मॉर्निंग एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम, हाउ आर यू ऑल। आई एम ग्रेट फॉर इंग्लिश लिटरेचर टीचर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ओपन पेज नंबर 55। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन रीडिंग एंड री एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द चैप्टर द वंडरफुल म्यूजिशियन। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड, आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड पेज 53 एंड 54 एंड वी हैव डन द रीडिंग। सो लेट्स डू द रीडिंग एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन। दे रीच द फार बैंक ऑफ द रिवर ऑफ डेथ। Orpheus climbed out and looked around him. He was at the gate of the Dark Kingdom. There stood a fierce dog. It was as big as a horse and it had three heads. Each head had a pair of fire red eyes and a large number of sharp yellow teeth. So what happened when Orpheus reached to the gate of the Dark Kingdom? He saw a dog that was very big like a horse and it was having three heads and every head was having two red eyes and a large number of yellow teeth. The dog saw Orpheus and began to show all its teeth. It was ready to attack Orpheus and tear him to pieces. However, Orpheus picked up his lyre and began to play. The music was soft and gentle. The dog lay down on its back and waved his leg in the air. Orpheus scratched the dog under all three hairy chins. It shut its six eyes and licked his fingers. Now, as soon as Orpheus saw the dog, he understood that there is something wrong is going to be happened. So he started to play his lyre. After hearing the music, the dog became soft and gentle, and it also was licking the fingers of Orpheus. "You're a nice old dog," said Orpheus. "You'll let me go through the gate, won't you?" The dog waved its tail and licked Orpheus again. With shaking hands, the musician opened the gate. A dark, twisting path led to the palace of the dark god Pluto. Orpheus followed it for many miles. Now Orpheus said to the dog that he was a very nice dog and allow him to go through the palace. So the dog allowed him to go to the palace, and Orpheus opened the gate which led to a twisting path, and it was having a walk of many miles. The dark god. At last Orpheus came into an open space. In front of him was a palace. The great doors were open wide. Orpheus walked in and found himself in a wide hall. There sat Pluto with his young wife Persephone at his side. When he came to a place, it was the palace of Pluto, who was sitting with his wife Persephone. "What are you doing here?" roared Pluto when he saw Orpheus. "No living man enters my halls. There must be some mistake. Who sent you here? Tell me, and I will punish him." Now, as Pluto saw Orpheus in the kingdom of the dead, he was very much angry, and he said he is going to punish the person who has sent him here. "There is no mistake," said Orpheus. "I came here to look for my wife Eurydice." Orpheus said that it was not a mistake. It is because Orpheus has come to look for his wife Eurydice because a snake bit her and she fell dead. So it was only a few days, but it seems like years. "Great Pluto, I cannot live without her. Let me take her home with me now." So Orpheus asked Pluto that he want to take Eurydice with him. Pluto looked at Persephone and whispered something. The young goddess whispered something back. She seemed to want her husband to grant Orpheus's wish. But the dark god shook his hand. Pluto looked at his wife Persephone, and so Persephone was telling in his voice that she wants that Orpheus's wish to take his wife back should be granted. But the dark god Pluto was not listening. So Orpheus took up his lyre and began to play it. He sang about love for Eurydice. He sang about her cruel death. He sang about his lonely life. The god's dark eyes became bright with tears. Persephone hid a lovely face in her hands and cried. The spirits of the dead came to listen and they cried too. So when Orpheus listened to all this, he started playing his lyre. And when Pluto and Persephone heard the song and the music of Orpheus, it was very sad. So they all started to cry. Till here we are studying, till page 56. So read it at home, try to understand, make your reading nice and try to understand the meaning of the difficult words and make sentences orally. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.